Keyword research for Etsy doesn't have to be hard. And with Marmalead Storm tool, it isn't. So if you want to flood your listings with new and improved keywords, it all starts with Storm. Let's jump in, figure out how. Hey guys, I'm Dylan from Marmalead, and welcome back to another How tutorial with Marmalead. Today we're taking a look at Marmalead's Storm tool. Storm is going to be a great tool to help you brainstorm keywords for your Etsy listings. It's going to help you figure out which 13 tags you should use for your listings. It's going to help you figure out keywords to put in your titles and your description. And overall, Storm is going to be a great brainstorming tool to have in your back pocket. First thing we got to do when it comes to Storm, obviously, is we're going to pull up Marmalead. We're going to take you through every step of the way. So I've got Marmalead pulled up right here. We're gonna see Storm on the left-hand column. It's got the lightning bolt symbol there. So before we start a new Storm, one of the things you're gonna be wondering, of course, is what the heck is Storm? Maybe why is it called that? Well, Storm's a great tool. It's gonna help you find keywords that you'd never even think of. Once you put in a seed keyword into Storm, Storm is literally gonna rain keywords down into Marmalead, and it's up to you to pick and choose the keywords that are appropriate for your listings. All you have to do here is click on New Storm, and then we're gonna type in a seed keyword to help Storm pull up some keyword suggestions for you. If you watched my other how-to video on how to use Marmalead's search tool, you know that when it comes to brainstorming Etsy keywords for my listings, I like to start vague. In this case though, with the Storm tool, it helps if you don't quite start so vague. That way Storm's gonna have a better idea of the type of listing that you wanna curate. So, rather than starting vague, what we could do is go to our Etsy search terms in our current Etsy shop. So, it's gonna be a great place to start is going over to the real search terms that buyers are actually using to find your current listings. So obviously whenever it comes to brainstorming keywords, you're gonna have a listing in mind that you want to optimize. So what you gotta do is jump over to Etsy, and we're going to go into our shop manager. This is a fake little shop that we created just to run some tests here. So I'm gonna click on shop manager. I'm gonna go down into stats that I'm already in. And then we're going to scroll down and find a listing that we want to optimize. In our case here, we're going to optimize this listing. And we're going to scroll further down to see these search terms. So these are going to be the search terms that real buyers are actually using to find your listings. In this case, this listing, we have buyers that are currently finding it using the keyword black pottery, hanging planner, vase, plant pot. So you could start with any one of these keywords that are real buyer search terms for your listings. You already know that people are using these keywords to find your listing. So Storm is gonna help you dig deeper into these keywords, offer some suggestions that you can incorporate onto your listing. So we're gonna take one of these keywords. In this case, we're gonna take black pottery. We're gonna jump back over into Storm, and we are going to start our Storm with black pottery. I want to take a moment to thank you for watching this video. Marmalead will change the way you look at your Etsy SEO while helping you increase your sales and productivity. If you've made it this far and you're still not using Marmalead in your Etsy shop, we'd like to invite you to use some of our free tools. Learn more in the description or at marmalead.com. Once you have your seed keyword typed in our case, it is black pottery, then Storm is going to flood Marmalead with keyword suggestions that are going to be related to that seed keyword. So again, Storm is using machine learning to take word and phrasing matches, similar shopper searches, popular keyword suggestions, and they're going to take all those and they're dumping them here into the Storm suggestions. So it's up to you to pick and choose the keywords that are going to be related to your listings, and you're going to dump them right here into your bucket. Some of the keywords are going to be more related to your listings than others, but again, it's up to you to tell Storm which ones those are. That way, Storm can learn from you and start to offer you keyword suggestions that are more so related to your listings. So what we're gonna do is quickly go through, dump the keywords we don't like, keep the keywords that we think are related to our listings, and then of course, the entire time, we wanna pay attention to these Marmameters right here. If you're not familiar with the Marmameters, I definitely recommend you go check out the How to Use Marmalead search tool. In that video, we take a deeper dive into these Marmameters, but essentially what we're doing here is we're going to show you the number of searches this keyword is expected to receive in the next 30 days, the number of clicks through engagement that this keyword is expected to receive within the next 30 days, and the amount of competitive listings that are using this exact same keyword on Etsy. So you're going to want to keep an eye on all three of these Marmameters here as we go through Storm. So again, let's start dumping in some keywords that are related to our listing, getting rid of the keywords we don't like. All of this we're going to keep in mind with our current listing that we're optimizing, of course. So if it's related to the listing that I'm optimizing, I'm putting it in my bucket, paying special attention to the keyword suggestions. I put in keywords like Italian pottery and Roseville pottery. Personally, I don't know what either of those keywords are. I don't know what those types of pots are, but because they're in all green, I'm gonna dump them in and I can check on that later on to see if my listing is related to these keywords in any way. Not too sure yet. Again, we're going to be dumping in keywords into our listing that are related to our listing. Keywords like gift for her are going to show up. Gift for her, gift for him, Mother's Day gift, Father's Day gift. Those keywords are of course going to have high searches and high engagement, but without a doubt, those keywords are always, always going to have high competition. All the keywords like gift for her, gift for him, those are without a doubt the most popular keywords on Etsy, because those are the type of searches that buyers are using when it comes to finding gifts for their significant other. We've talked about this before, but the average shopper uses Etsy kind of like Google. They're not always sure what they're looking for. A lot of the times they're gonna start with a very, very vague search in Etsy, kind of like gift for her. They're just doing some shopping. They're trying to get ideas for what kind of gifts and what kind of products are out there on Etsy. So in our case, we are not going to be using gift for her for this listing. You could use it for your listing if you want to build up some keyword credibility to try to rank for gift for her. But again, those keywords are really going to be really hard to rank for. So we're not going to focus our time on that. Housewarming gift is another one of those types of keywords we're not necessarily going to focus our time on. Kitchen decor, rustic home decor, all of those are kind of in the same ballpark as gift for her, housewarming gift, but it's more closely related to what our keyword is here. So we're going to add it on here just in case we want to come back to those keywords later on. Again, as we dump in keywords into our bucket that we like, get rid of keywords that we don't like, what Storm is going to do is they're going to give you more suggestions at the bottom. So we've got tons of suggestions that are down here. As we've been doing this, Storm's been adding more suggestions down. So we're just gonna keep doing this for as long as you want to. I mean, you could create as long as a list as you want and just keep going through and adding in more keywords. It's up to you whenever you think you've got a good enough list that you can go back through this bucket and start to pick and choose from this bucket and, you know, save these keywords and add them to your own specific lists that you have. So let's keep doing it a little bit longer and we'll see if we can find out some other really good keywords for our listings. Keyword like this, Bulbasaur planner. What the Storm tool can really help you do is if you are one of those Etsy sellers that you're thinking you want to start creating different products, products that you don't typically make just yet, and you're thinking, what other products can I create that are somewhat related to the current product that I make? You can look through the Storm and you can get ideas of the types of markets that are, you know, pretty wide open for you to move yourself into. Obviously, Bulbasaur planter, it's got high searches, high engagement, not a whole lot of competition. Something you should be worried about with this particular keyword is just copyright, right? Bulbasaur. But you can kind of see that this is a good example of a different market that we can tap into. It's a suggestion based off of Storm, so kind of keep these different keywords in mind. For our case, we're not going to be interested in making Bulbasaur planters. We're going to get rid of that. We're also not going to make butt planters. cement planter, that looks like a good one. Concrete planter, copper planter, custom planter box. So let's keep going through these real quick. You're gonna get to a point where Storm is really gonna run out of ideas that are closely related to your listing, and that's okay. Once you kind of feel like you've gotten to that point, I like to just take one final scan through everything, see if there's anything else I can include in my bucket. Okay. I think we've pretty much got a lot of keywords that we can choose from. So now that we've got a pretty full bucket, what we can do is we can further optimize the keywords that are on this list. But before we do anything else, we're going to want to make sure that we save this storm. If we were to hit the back button or go to any other menu tab, then storm is going to just erase this list that we've already created. It's not a huge deal because all you have to do is just type in that same seed keyword into the storm tool, and you can pick and choose from your keyword lists again. But to keep your sanity, definitely make sure you save the storm. That way, if you do jump over into your listings, you jump back over into storm, you can see that the storm you created with your seed keywords is going to be listed right there. So you can jump back in anytime. All right, so once we've got our storm saved, what we can do is we can start to create lists based off of these keywords that are in our bucket. Before we do that, I'm going to show you one quick example of something else you can do with storm with your keywords. Obviously, we only took one keyword from the search terms. We didn't take any other keyword suggestions, but you can go back then, create another storm related to other keyword suggestions that you have coming straight from Etsy. Again, these are search terms that buyers are using to find your listings, so why not curate your listing with keywords that real buyers are using? So you could take hanging planner, vase, plant pot. You could take those three different keywords, make different storms based off of all three of those. Some of the keywords that you're going to see that are suggested to you are going to be overlaps, of course, but you could find some other keywords that didn't show up in this storm based off of those other keywords, just because they're going to have different suggested search terms, and they're going to have different phrasing and word matches. So that's where it's going to be helpful to kind of go back into your search terms, find some other keywords that could be listed there. So anyways, we're going to go back in real quick. So once we have our storm saved, it's going to show up here, always in the storm section. You can go back into the black pottery storm, the one that we've just created. And these keywords are going to remain in your bucket for as long as you keep them on your storm. So as long as you don't hit the red X, they're going to remain in your bucket. What's going to be really helpful with saving your storm is you're going to be able to come back to that at any point in the future and check to see if these marmometers have changed over time. Obviously, they are going to change based off of the seasonality of the type of keyword that you're looking at. These different meters are going to be different throughout the year. So that's why you always want to save your storm so you can come back in, check to see if the keywords that you have pulled off of storm and put in your listings, if those are going to be any different. This is just one of the ways you can use Marmalead to just check in and see if these keywords have changed over time. So after you've got your bucket nice and full of the keywords that are related to your listing, what are we going to do from here? What I like to do is add them to a list. So I'm going to create a list that's specific to the listing that I'm optimizing here. So let's create a new list. Again, our seed keyword is black pottery. So that's just what I'm going to name our list. But you can name it whatever you want. It has no reflection of how it's going to affect your keywords. So we've created that list. And we're going to add cement planner in there. We're going to add floor vase, Roseville pottery. We're going to pull that one off. Concrete planner. That's definitely a really good one. Italian pottery. No, we're going to pull that one off too. Mini planner. Yeah, say we want to make little mini rustic planter pots. That's kind of like a little niche market for planter pots. Definitely save that keyword. If you want to make wall hanging planters, that's a good place. That's a good, you know, market to move into with your pottery. Modern planner. Yeah, let's throw it on there. Hanging planner, stoneware mug. Thing is I already have a lot of these in my bucket because I liked them. So I like them well enough to keep them on my list, which is fine. But we're really just trying to think of the different keywords that are going to be related to this listing that we chose. And we're adding those onto our list just so, again, you can get an idea of how you can organize the different keywords that you're brainstorming. So you go back into your list. We go into black pottery. And then from there, we can see all the different keywords we put on this list. So if you want to create lists for any specific tracking method that you want to have in your shop, go for it. And that pretty much sums up how you can use Marmalead Storm Tool. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give us a like and subscribe. You can see how Storm is going to help you brainstorm keywords. Don't forget to follow along with us, guys, because we're going to continue putting out videos just like this one. We're going to take a deep dive into the tools available to you in Marmalead, show you how to use them, and we're going to be offering tips and tricks along the way. You've got Richie and Gordon who do the jam. You've got Lisa and Jade who have their With a Twist video series. So now we've got these how tutorial videos that we're going to be continuing to offer for our subscribers. So we hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, happy selling.